Okay, so I know I was supposed to get that Venusaur analysis out to you guys like last Friday, but a couple of things came up. I had a few exams and I didn't really have time to record and edit that video. Plus, my new debit card is still in the mail on its way to me, and my Nintendo Switch Online membership expired, so I have to wait for that to come in for me to renew it. That means I actually don't have any footage of me using Venusaur on stream to make a video, but I do have plenty of footage of me using Max Airstream. I figured since I'm pushing the Venusaur video until this Saturday, then I shouldn't have you guys waiting until then for a new video. So let's address the issue of Max Airstream. By now, it's no surprise to you guys that a lot of people aren't fans of VGC 2020, but it's personally one of my favorite formats I've ever played, and I've been playing since 2015. 5 years isn't much compared to a lot of old heads, but it's definitely enough for me to have a valid opinion on this sort of thing. Personally, I find Dynamax to be super interesting when it comes to competitive play, and it encourages people to build Pokemon much bulkier and play more defensively, which has always been my preferred way of team building, so me and this format are actually clicking really well. But on the other side of things, Dynamax could encourage people to build teams entirely around their Dynamax Pokemon, making team building super one-dimensional. And in a way, it makes Hyper Offense much more viable, which honestly is super annoying. The main offender of encouraging this playstyle has to be Max Airstream. Max Airstream is honestly the most broken move in the history of VGC. If you've played this game long enough, I really don't need to justify this stance to you. You know that this is true. But let me explain this to the less informed. Now, before I get into things, I want to preface a few things. I know that there are plenty of ways of countering Max Airstream when it comes to Trick Room, Paralysis, setting up your own Tailwind, etc. However, it's just such a good move that there's very little incentive not to have it on just about every team you make. So that's why I believe this move is just completely busted. That, and I'm not actually a VGC hater, I actually love VGC. If you guys love it too, then you should definitely click the subscribe button. Now, listen, it's not my problem if you have commitment issues, but if you don't turn on that notification button, then the subscription means nothing, okay? Did I guilt you into it yet? Did you click the bell? Alright, good, let's talk Pokemon. Max Airstream is a flying type max move that increases the user and its active ally Pokemon speed by one stage if it connects with an opposing Pokemon, which isn't too difficult considering it breaks protection. You can only block this move and its effect with Max Guard, which in a lot of cases isn't the most effective way of using your Dynamax in a game. It's pretty much like triggering a fight or flight response then choosing both. Like all other max moves, its base power depends on which move it comes out from, but the two main moves you'll see get turned into Max Airstream are Air Slash and Hurricane. Air Slash becomes 130 base power Max Airstream, while Hurricane becomes 140 base power Max Airstream. Max moves are absurdly powerful, especially Max Airstream since it's flying type. Because flying is only resisted by rock, steel, and electric types, most Pokemon get hit by full damage, if not super effective damage. It's the Pokemon equivalent of getting hit in the head by a ceiling fan, if that ceiling fan was a jet engine that chases you down if you survive. I honestly find the power of this move to be baffling. Max Knuckle boosts attack, and Max Ooze boosts special attack, but they're balanced by getting capped at 90 base power, even if the base move is stronger than that. While speed isn't directly an offensive stat like attack or special attack, increasing speed makes a Pokemon's offensive potential grow so much. For example, Vileplume and Venusaur. These Pokemon have the exact same typing and play very similarly. They're both Chlorophyll Sun abusers that like to be fast offensive Pokemon. Vileplume has 110 special attack, but Venusaur only has 100. While Vileplume in just about every case has better damage output than Venusaur, it has a significantly harder time finding opportunities to use its moves. This is because it's so much slower than Venusaur, sitting at only 50 base speed, while Venusaur is 80. Venusaur is going to be dropping Sludge Bombs and Sleep Powders left and right before anything can move. Meanwhile, Vileplume just got nae-naed on by Scarf Excadrill for the 8th game in a row. Now, let's apply this logic to Max Airstream. Togekiss is able to throw out Max Airstreams and become more dangerous just by the fact it's able to outspeed Dragapult after one or two of those. Dragapult does have the potential to threaten Togekiss if it's faster than it and has the opportunity to hit with a powerful ghost move, but once Togekiss is faster, it's much more dangerous. If my previous statements weren't enough evidence to prove how busted this move is, usage stats only further prove my point. I feel like there's this unspoken rule of team building that if something can Max Airstream, then it must, at least when it comes to aggressive offensive Pokemon. Pokemon that have access to flying moves would have very little incentive to run them if it weren't for the speed boost it gains from Max Airstream. Dragapult already has trouble deciding on a fourth move between Dragon Dance, Will-O-Wisp, Steel Wing, and Ally Switch. All of them could reasonably fit onto a Dragapult set, but the allure of just running the haha zoom move is just way too much to resist. I can forgive Dragazolt for running Aerial Ace because once it's done Dynamaxing, it's the only move that it can't miss despite Hustle, but once Air Slash, Inteleon, and Acrobatics pass him and hit the field, I have to start pointing out some issues. Like I said, speed boost for just one Pokemon is already busted for such a powerful move, but a speed boost for it and its partner is way too strong. Because speed tiers update dynamically in this generation, mid-turn, the order in which Pokemon move can change. Your Dragapult can max Airstream next to a Darmanitan, boosting both of their speeds. While that Darmanitan would originally be slower than the Choice-Scarf Excadrill across the field when the moves were selected, it now is always faster and can KO it. Now there are plenty of Pokemon that want to max Airstream, like I said, if it can, then it must, but there's a select list of Pokemon that benefit from max Airstream much more than others. Gyarados in particular is a common choice. It can turn its once unviable move Bounce into a powerful physical flying type move that can easily score a KO, boosting its speed and attack because of its ability Moxie. From this point on, it's not uncommon to see Gyarados' power snowball and do tons of damage to the opposing team. It's essentially an offensive Dragon Dance, which I really shouldn't have to explain is really, really good. Early in the series, we actually saw Braviary get used to some success running Max Airstream as well. Having the ability Defiant made it really tough to stop Braviary short of burning. It just got faster and faster, punishing any attempts of intimidating it by just gaining attack instead. Finally, the worst offender of all, the reason I hate Max Airstream with a passion, is because this move is 100% the only reason Crit Togekiss is viable. For those of you who don't know, Crit Togekiss is a variant of Togekiss that runs Scope Lens and the ability Super Luck to boost its crit rate to 50%. If Crit Kiss didn't have the ability to speed boost every turn, then a 50% chance to crit wouldn't be nearly as appealing as Babiri Berry or Safety Goggles. Crit Kiss is good, and it's all this move's fault. That being said, I'm still going to run Crit Kiss on like 90% of my teams because it's free points, man. Thank you so much for watching the video, guys. I know that this video was a little bit different than what I usually do. It's just something that, I'll call it filler content. I want to put out some informative VGC content explaining why something is so good or explaining how something works, but not in a long form like my analysis videos. And that's just sort of to fill in the gaps between other videos if I do have time. So if you guys enjoy this, leave a like and subscribe. I would really appreciate that. And I want to thank especially my Patreons. You guys are amazing. You guys have been supporting the channel through this very troubling time. And you guys are just the best. Be sure to click on all my social media links, whether it be Twitch, Twitter, Discord, or whatever you want. Thank you so much, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Have a nice night.